Back at a really old site I found this spring when this corn was only about 18 inches tall. The farmer said, have at it, just be careful of the corn. And I said, absolutely. And 1857 gone by 72, but this is a good site. Ground zero is very strong and loud, large. I nailed a couple early at large scents, 21 and 32 or something. A 61 token, Civil War token. I got some harmonica reeds and some oil lamp parts, but Brandon had to work and I didn't have to work. I got the next 4 days off, so me and Jared Bob are going to see what we can do. All right, guys, talk to you later. Hey, I think I may have a coin or a token. 65 to 67. Never even got into the chime of a 70. So it might be a token. Might be a button too. I don't know what it is, but I got a solid signal and I see green. Oop, I feel shankage. It's a button. Yeah. The flat button. Huh. Cool beans. All right, we're not 100% sure. Still in the cornfield. But Jerbob might have dug an ox knob. If I can remember, when I found mine, then mine is just like the one you found last summer.
Yeah, there's threads
on. Yep, there was different variations of them, and all there has to be is threads down there. And we're gonna go with the ox knob. Cool beans. I asked him. I said, "You dig something?" He says, "Yeah." I said, "What is it?" "I don't know. A ball."
Yeah, that's an ox knob.
Sweet.
Now I got the dirt out of it.
All right. I was happy. I'm in the real heavy ground zero. It's chirping like crazy, but I was able to lock onto a 70s in all directions. And I see something right there. I might want to see what that is. Ooh, it's round. Oh, it feels like I feel a shank. I do. Button. Any design on it? Button. Not much of one if there is. Get rid of the light. Cool beans. Well, I left Jerbob in the corn. A lot of iron. Very hard to single out tones, doing circles every five steps. And I also know the gentleman who owns this alfalfa field next to it. It's a different property owner, but it's the same home site. I think the long fence row right here was the driveway. In fact, I know it was. It is on the map. Anywho, I see what my tone was. I'm gonna say another button. Yep, big one. cool. Oh, another flat button. I don't see any words on it. I see a little ring around the shank. All right, let's try to find something else. Beautiful day, a little chilly. That sun's beating hard. And we are west of Montgomery, Michigan. And the field that Brandon is currently swinging in is the 1857 WR Montgomery. So we're wondering if the city was, or the village was named after him. Hopefully we find some cool stuff. Alrighty guys, hopefully we'll see you soon. Just hollered largy, and then he goes, this is not a largy. Let's go see what he's got. Token presidential, maybe
Canadian, I think. 1820 something.
Holy Toledo
is right. All right, let's see. 1820 exactly. Where's my notes actually? It's got some kind of like two shovels crossed on one side.
Good sight, huh?
I'm gonna put it in my mouth.
It's okay, I'll watch it.
Okay. So that's Canada.
I'll get back to you when he gets it cleaned. Get a close up of it in the sun. Oh, sweet. Very sweet. Let's see the back.
It's like a sailboat, maybe? I don't know. Pretty cool.
Awesome, man.
All right. Not bad. Decided to go. I figured this is it from what I'm found out there. You know, decided to go to the front, deal with the pop cans.
Deal with the pop cans, yeah.
Yep.
I was just thinking about my next pass coming back farther away from the pop cans.
I know, I did that already, so figured I'd see what's in the front.
Awesome. Good job, Brandon.
Commercial. Change.
Brandon just said he dug an Indian. Nice.
What's the key date I'm looking for?
77, yeah. Brandon did her again. Sounds like he's got a token. Maybe I better scoot up along the road.
You got a 5-cent token.
Oh, that is so cool. Let me see the other side. Flip
it over. Just says EC on it.
Oh, hang on. Let's turn it around. Oh, be darn.
Good find, Brandon.
Thank you.
All right. I'm pretty sure this is a coin. Let's see. Well, regardless, I'll grab it. There we are. Whoa, I'm zoomed way in.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty dirty. This is my 77.
And again.
99.
Sweet.
Ooh, she's beautiful too.
Awesome.
I'll take some. Thanks, bro.
Hell yeah.
Well, I just dug a knock snap. Screaming in my ear. I wasn't sure what it was. Those are always cool to find. That's only my second one. Jerry dug one yesterday that was almost completely round. Cool beans. I guess Jerry Bob just dug a Civil War button. Cool beans. You get that, Jerry Bob?
Yeah.
Sweet. I got bad news for you.
1960s.
Yep.
Vietnam War.
Nah, it could be World War One. It could be World War Two. Yep.
I'm saying two.
Yep.
It looks like the buttons on it.
It's beautiful though.
Vietnam.
Yeah, I think I just dug a ring. We're up at the schoolhouse now. It's Big Bean Field. There's Jerry and Brandon. And they had a real slight 50s tone. I think it's a ring. Child's ring. Copper. Cool. Brandon's dug two Indians a foot apart. He's done really well. He was slamming them back in his pocket, so I didn't want to bother him to go up and video him. But I think I just got one too. Either a flying eagle or a token. It ain't an Indian. Can't rule out weedy. It is. It's a weedy. Must be this schoolhouse was still active in the 40s and 50s probably.
It's gotta be early.
Yeah. A lot of them were still going in the 40s and 50s. See it too sunny. Maybe you guys can. Alright, man. Now this might be shotgun head stamp, but I'm not 100% sure. Yep, it is. Okay. Well, we're at the old schoolhouse still. We'll probably be here the rest of the day. Done pretty good. I just found this. It's a real ornate piece. Not sure what it goes to. Maybe a desk, a school desk. Maybe in the crotch of a school desk leg. I'm not sure. But, all right. See you later. Well, I closed the hole back up and I swung over it and he had a brother. Check it out. Pretty cool, huh? I'm not sure what it goes to, but it's ornate as heck, and so I'll keep them. I like this piece better than the other one. Very cool. All right. It was very deep and very loud. I think I just dug a keg tap. What's that doing that at school, Jerry Bob just wondered. Cool. Okay, I got something big. I don't know what it is. Let me clean it up a little bit. Sweet. Oh, I got a Canadian 1 cent like you've been digging with those big, the big Q circle in the back. Sweet. Okay, now let's go see Jerbob. He dug the largy, it sounds like. I knew there should be a largy in here somewhere, as old as this is. Hoping anyway. Oh.
I did just go like
that. Oh! Oh shit, it was just like that, huh?
Just like that.
Oh, be darned.
No digging that one.
Here you go. Sweet. Said he dug a butt. Military. Wow. Today is the day we hate Brandon. Instead of being me all the time. What do you got, bud?
1901 Indian. She's pretty.
Oh, yeah. Good job.
Thanks.
Holy moly, 5.5 hours later. We're gonna do a wrap up. Here's my stuff. Cool things. I don't, Oxnob, Canadian, 1844, half penny. I got an Indian, 1919, wheat penny. I think that's a lantern part, and that's a pocket knife edge. And I must have came across where they threw their old desks at the schoolhouse, because I think these are parts of the old desk. And Jerbob said that's a, it says Goodyear right on it. That's a valve stem, probably to a tractor. Another cool keg tap. And I don't know what this is, but it's cool. I don't know. It's got... got a hole on each end. That's cool. I found an old ring. A guy told me what it was. It had something to do with the farm implements. It's probably from the 30, 40s or 50s. Chain was on each side. Right there and right there. Found a very old, because it's white, I'm thinking, lead ball in a child ring. Yep. Okay. So that's my take for the day. Save the best for last. Jerbob, help me out here. We got the ox knob. We got a, ooh, that's the back of a shotgun or a rifle butt, ain't it? That's cool. Buckle. Yeah, there's that button. He dug that. It's got an oak acorn on it.
That's great.
Porcelain inside the button. Isn't that neat?
Yeah, he showed me that.
Button. I think that's another button. Yep. Oh, there's the large scent he dug today. Only large scent dug today. 1846. And then that, I'm going to guess World War I. The site's old enough for that. That's a button, coat button. Looks like he got into some of that desk ornate stuff too. The reason why I say it's desk is because I dug this. And this looks like the leg, part of the leg of one. So that's where all that stuff came from close by. So, yep. Good job today, Jerry Bob, and the man that can, the man that can kick our butts.
Today, anyway.
Did so. Let's check out this board. Holy moly, check it out. He's got a couple buttons there that could be very old. Revolutionary War, maybe. At least a little one. Big one, very well could be. Not an expert on buttons. Looks like he got some shell casings. And that's a valve stem to a vehicle. It's not a Model T Ford, I don't think, but it's back there around that time frame. Belt buckle, it looks like a flat button. What is this brand on, do you know?
Some words on it, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either.
Toothbrush out.
Yep. All right, let's start on the coins. Ooh, we got a dog license too. Bet you that's an old. Did you get that here?
Yep. Or at the... No date.
Sweet.
On it.
That's too bad. All right, he got his 19. Looks like 14 wheat penny. Oh, there's the 14. There's 1913. Cool. I don't see many of them. I dug one. Dig one, though. He's got a good for 5 cents in trade token. Amazing shape. It's got the letters EC on it. Very cool. That's a Canadian. I bet you that's Canadian.
Canadian half-penny.
The 1820?
1820.
It's amazing.
Upper Canada.
1820. Wow. Then we have a 1870. You in the 70s, Indian heads. You're going to pluck the 77. You watch. 1881, I believe, Indian. 1906 Indian. 1901 Indian. 1879 Indian. Good Lord. And what's that one on the outside? Looks like 1907. What is this one? A 73?
I got a 270s. One's a 70 and one's a 70.
You got a 79. You've got a 70.
73, I'll be doing.
And a one on the corner, 73. Good Lord. That deserves a big.
Not a bad day.
Good about bringing it in. That was fun.
Yes, it was.
All right, guys. We will see you on the flip-flop.